Dolls back at it again with another video. And today I was like, you know what? I want to turn my dolls into Disney princesses. Then I realized that I don't have any Disney princess dresses for my dolls. So I was like, wait a minute. Let's make my dolls into modern day Disney princesses. So if the Disney princesses were in this time period, I have a feeling this is what they'd be dressing like. Let's get right into the video.
Tale as old as time. Song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.
So first up we have Princess Belle, and actually I don't have many yellow clothings besides this yellow top, so I didn't really incorporate a lot of yellow into her outfit, but I did incorporate these little jean overalls that have little roses on them that kind of reminds her of like her rose theme. But unfortunately my overalls are kind of broken, so they only have one clasp around the arm thing. Anyways, whatever. For her hair I did Belle's classic half up half down bun thing, and I thought it turned out really cute. I also ended up curling her hair because Rebecca's hair is super curly and Belle's hair is kind of wavy, so, you know, why not?
Small to say the least, both a little scared, not a one prepared, Beauty and the Beast. Ah, ah, ah,
no, it's true that visions are seldom all.
Next up, we have Sleeping Beauty, and she's probably the least popular Disney princess of all. But Julie recently came back from the doll hospital, and I wanted to make her into one of the princesses, so yeah. Sleeping Beauty wears a lot of pink and blue, depending on which dress you like. And I think if she was a modern day teenager or something like that, she'd be super lazy, just because she sleeps a lot. So I put together this outfit, actually using two of the clothing hacks that I did from one of my previous videos, the plain shirt and the shirt jacket thing. And then I just did a little simple braid in her hair, nothing too much, nothing too snazzy, and I also added this little pink choker that I actually didn't film putting on, but it's still there. Next up we have Ariel, who is actually one of my least favorite princesses, but I remember at my old school a lot of the girls in my class loved Ariel, so I just felt like I needed to make her for the sake of the people at my old school. I gave her some green shorts and a purple tube top from the same clothing DIY hack video that I've mentioned previously. I also couldn't decide which shoes to put on her, but I ended up choosing some turquoise ones. For her hair, I just simply finger curled it and then added a little flower clip, because yay, she has a flower in her hair. And I think she actually looks really cute, so yeah. Next up, we have one of my favorite princesses, and that is Jasmine. Jasmine, honestly, I absolutely love her. I actually haven't seen the live action Aladdin yet, but I've seen the original and I really love it. Jasmine is currently the only Disney princess who actually wears pants instead of a dress in the majority of pictures she's in. So I just had to put her in some pants and a crop top, because she actually does wear a crop top, and then some shoes. And then I put this headband in her hair because it kind of reminded me of that crown she wears. And then she has a pretty distinct hairstyle. It's like the bubble ponytail, and then the pieces of hair like going around her ears. So I tried my best to replicate that. It actually ended up really well. And last but definitely not least is Mulan. I love Mulan. She is my downright favorite Disney princess of all of them. She's great, she's awesome, she's everything in between. It was a little hard to recreate her outfit because she just has a lot of different outfits throughout the entire thing, but I tried to go for her main outfit that she's wearing when you search up Mulan. So I gave her this little red tube top that's actually made from a sleeve of an old shirt, and then some cute little patterned shorts, and then a cute little denim jacket with a little flower next to it, and then I put her in some Mary Jane shoes because though she's a tomboy and though I think she would wear tennis shoes, I think those shoes actually match the original princess a lot better. Then I put her hair into a ponytail but let two strands fall loose from it to give a little bit of a facial framing thing. I don't know, don't listen to me, I'm a little weird. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I really enjoyed making this video and I hope you really enjoyed watching this video. Overall, it was just a really fun experience and I actually think I might do it again sometime. Who knows? Let me know down below what other princesses you might want to see. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to remember that I post every single Saturday, and Thursdays is Magi Academy. Keep on the lookout for that, and goodbye!